Hello, one and all. Greetings from Technocrats KIT Group, Bhopal. This is Dr. Anoop Kumar Pathariya, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, delivering you an expert lecture on performance evaluation of mixed gases steam cycle. Under this topic, I am going to cover following content. First is what is a mixed cycle. Second, different configurations of mixed cycle. Mathematical modeling of components of mixed cycle. Performance comparison of different configurations of mixed cycle. Some concluding facts about the power plant based upon the mixed cycle. And future possibilities of research in the field of mixed cycle. Friends, as we all know that future economic growth of country crucially depends on the long-term availability of energy from sources that are affordable, accessible, and environmental friendly. In a very short period of history, the gas turbines, which is the youngest of major energy conversion devices, has changed and created global markets in aviation, marine, propulsion, and in generation of electric power. In year 1939, the first gas turbine had the thermal efficiency of about 18%. But over the years, engineers and researchers have worked to raise the turbine inlet temperatures, increase pressure ratios, enhance combustion, perfect new material, and improve design so that modern gas turbine are now achieving an efficiency of 40 to 45% in simple cycle operation. While in combined cycle operations, the gas turbine has become the thermal efficiency superstar of the electric power plant, bringing about cycle thermal efficiencies exceeding more than 60%. This diagrams gives you the view of the basic components of a gas turbine cycle. It includes a compressor, a combustion chamber where the combustion of fuel takes place, preferably the natural gas are used as the fuel for the gas turbines, and a turbine where the expansion of the combust gases takes place so that the useful work can be withdrawn. Now, what is the purpose of this gas turbine technology? The gas turbine technology is used to extract the maximum quantity of energy from the working fluid. The working fluid, which may be of course gas, derived from the combustion of the natural gases. The second purpose is to convert it into useful work with maximum efficiency by means of plant which is having maximum reliability, minimum cost, minimum supervision, and minimum starting time. Friends, the exhaust which is coming out of gas turbine has a temperature of nearly 600 degrees centigrade. Now, the challenge is in how such heat, which is going as waste in exhaust, how this heat can be utilized. As I have told you, the heat rejected by gas turbine is highly appreciable as the exhaust temperature varies from 450 degrees centigrade to 650 degrees centigrade depending upon pressure ratio and turbine inlet temperature. Now, this waste energy may be utilized to produce steam in a heat recovery steam generator. Now, the steam generated by use of the recovered heat from the heat recovery steam generator may be expanded in a steam turbine to develop additional power based on Rankine cycle. It may also be utilized for process heating, like in cogeneration plants, or it may fan with the combustion chamber, gets heated up to the turbine inlet temperature and expands in gas turbine, which is known as mixed cycle plants. Now, my emphasis in this lecture is on the use of mixed cycle. Let's try to elaborate that what is a mixed cycle. A mixed cycle utilizes two working fluids in one power cycle to improve the power output and thermal efficiency. The steam injected cycle, humidified air gas turbine are the few examples of the mixed cycle. The types of mixed cycle may be steam injected gas turbine cycles, humid air injected turbine cycles, and humid air turbine cycle. This figure gives you a schematic of simple steam injected gas turbines. You may observe that a water feed pump is feeding the water which is passing through the HRSG. HRSG is getting heat from the exhaust of the gas turbine. The steam generated in the drums located in the HRSG is fed into the combustion chamber, and few of the steam may be taken out for the process heating. This is the another configuration used in the mixed cycle plants. Here you may observe a train of compressor is there. From the production of the compressed air, this compressed air is mixed with the steam to form humid air, which in turn is passed through the HRSG and fed into the combustion chamber. This is the another type of mixed gas turbine cycle known as head cycle or humid air turbine cycle. In this figure, you may observe that air exiting the low pressure compressor, sequentially cooled by various intercoolers, water circulated intercooler using pump 2. Pump 1 provides makeup water to the intercooler 2, which is then mixed with saturated water ahead of the intercooler 1. An intercooler 3 dissipating heat to ambient. Intercooler 3 also allows minimizing the high pressure compressor work. And also, when makeup water flow in intercooler 2 is insufficient to accomplish maximum air cooling. A similar sequence is arranged for downstream of high pressure compressor. After coolers serve like intercoolers. The aftercooler 1 further heats the mixture of two streams of water used for inter and after cooling. Aftercooler 1 can be placed immediately after the high pressure compressor or immediately after the low pressure compressor, depending upon the air temperature at the exit of high pressure compressor and mass flow rate of air required for the production of unit kilowatt of power. Friends, this injecting of steam or water in gas turbine is not a new idea. Earlier, water injection was used for the thrust augmentation, which was once common in jet aircraft engines. Although nowadays, fans commonly serve this purpose. It is now standard practice to inject water or steam into the gas turbine to control the NOx emission, NOx, which is the harmful gas for the environment. Now, how the performance can be evaluated of the mixed cycle based power plants? For predicting the performance of any system, you require a proper selection of performance parameters. Now, performance parameters can be classified into independent parameters and dependent parameters. In this study, independent parameters are compressor pressure ratio, compressor inlet temperature, turbine inlet temperature, gas turbine blade temperature, different configurations of the mixed cycle, different cooling means used to cool the turbine blades, mass flow rate of the humid air, steam inlet temperature and pressure, moisture content, etc. The dependent parameters are gas turbine efficiency, specific power output of gas turbine, specific fuel consumption, stack temperature, mass of steam generated per kilogram of gas, and coolant flow rate. Now, there are a few configurations which are used for the study of the mixed cycle based power plants. This particular figure gives you the view of a configuration based upon basic gas turbine. This configuration is known as SIBGT, which is steam injected basic gas turbine cycle. Here you may observe that for mixing the steam in the combustion chamber, the steam is produced in the HRSG. The water is fed from one pump one to the derater. From the derater, the water goes to the drum where it is heated to be converted into steam, and which is used, which may be used for the process heating. Now, the steam coming out, the water coming out of the derater is pumped by pump 2 into the another drum, which also gets heat from the HRSG. This and converts the water into the superheated steam, which in turn is fed into the combustion chamber CC. Now, here you may observe the dotted lines. Dotted line shows the coolant air. The coolant air is bled from the various points of the compressor and fed into the gas turbines for the purpose of blade cooling. This is the TS diagram representing the SIBGT cycle. Another configuration which uses the intercooling, this configuration is known as SIICGT, steam injected intercooled gas turbine cycle. Here, as we all know, that intercooling brings down the compressor work, and in order to get the advantage of this, the intercooling is introduced in this particular configuration. This is the TS representation of the steam injected intercooled gas turbine cycle. Another configuration which uses the reheating, as you all know that reheating increases the temperature of the gas after a few stages, and which in turn gives you the higher efficiency. This is the TS representation of steam injected reheated gas turbine. Now this configuration utilizes the advantages of intercooling and reheating both. The configuration is known as SIICRGT, that is steam injected intercooled reheat gas turbines. You may observe that there are two compressors, C1 and C2, the low pressure compressor C1 and high pressure compressor C2. And you may also observe the two gas turbines GT1 and GT2. This is the TS representation of the SIICRGT cycle. Now, this figure represents the configuration of HAI cycle. Now, in HAI cycle, gas turbine cycle plant, an external supply of preheated, humidified, pressurized air is used to be injected into the gas turbine downstream of the compressor and upstream of the combustor. For producing the humid air for the gas turbine plant, a separate electric motor driven compressor train with two stages intercooling, once through partial boiler HRSG, that is heat recovery steam generator, using gas turbine exhaust as energy input, and steam air mixers are employed. The pressure of the compressed air through compressor train and pressure of steam generated is more or less the same, which mixes in a mixer, and after that it is preheated in a recuperator before being injected into the downstream of compressor and upstream of the combustor. The gas turbine exhaust passing through HRSG goes to atmosphere through the exhaust stack. Now this represents the TS diagram of HAI cycle, which is known as humid air injected cycle. Now this particular diagram shows the head cycle, which is humid air turbine cycle. Here you may observe that the presence of series of intercoolers and aftercoolers. Air exiting the low pressure compressor sequentially cooled by water recirculated from the saturators, bottom intercooler 1 using pump 2. Pump 1 provides makeup water, it is intercooler 2, which is then mixed with saturated water ahead of the intercooler 1. An intercooler 3 dissipating heat to ambient. Intercooler 3 allows minimizing the high pressure compressor work, also when makeup water flow in intercooler 2 is insufficient to accomplish maximum air cooling. A similar sequence is arranged downstream of the high pressure compressor, after coolers serve like intercoolers. The aftercooler 1 further heats the mixture of two streams of water. Aftercooler 1 can be placed immediately after the high pressure compressor, or immediately after the low pressure compressor, depending upon the air temperature at the exit of high pressure compressor, and mass flow rate of air required for the production of a unit kilowatt of the power. Now this diagram represents the temperature entropy diagram for the head cycle. Now to evaluate the performance of the mixed gas turbine cycle, different mathematical modeling were done, mathematical modeling of the components were done. The various components of the mixed cycle, like air and gas, the compressor, heat exchangers like intercoolers, aftercoolers, recuperators, combustion chamber, gas turbine, cooling means, pump, derater, heat recovery steam generator. Now the mathematical modeling of all these components were done in order to analyze the performance of the mixed cycle. Now friends, the gas turbine blade cooling is very much necessary for any gas turbine, because without the blade cooling, the blades may not withstand up to 100 hours of operation. So in order to obtain the maximum life cycle of the blades, these blade cooling means are used. Here we are using the two types of blade cooling. One is open loop cooling and other is closed loop cooling. The objective is to keep the matter temperature at the safe level, in despite of comprising of super alloys, the blade material cannot withstand the high temperature of the gas. Thus, it needs to be cooled. Another objective to ensure a long creep life, low oxidation rates and low thermal stresses. Now, as I told you, the options available for the cooling of the plates are open loop cooling and closed loop cooling. Under the open loop cooling, air internal convection cooling AICC, air film cooling AFC, air transpiration cooling ATC, steam internal convection cooling SICC, steam film cooling SFC, and steam transpiration cooling STC may be used. Now under the closed loop cooling, the CLSC, which is the closed loop steam cooling, means it may also be used. Now this diagrams give you the schematic of the cooled gas turbine with open and closed loop blade cooling. You may observe that the air is blocked from the compressor from the various points. Now it is always kept in mind while heating the air from the compressor that the pressure of the blood air should always meet the pressure of the gas which is expanding inside the gas turbine at various stages. Now steam as a coolant may also be used. Now steam can be bled from the steam generated at the HRSG, that is the heat recovery steam generator. Now the modeling of the open loop internal convection cooling is shown in this diagram. You may observe the path of the hot gas and the path of the coolant, which may be air or the steam. The heat transfer to the coolant is given by HG ASG multiplied by TG minus TD, Tg represents the temperature of the gas, Tb represents the blade temperature, Tsg represents the surface area, and Hg of course represents the enthalpy of the gas. Now this particular diagram gives you the view of the model of open loop of film cooling. By certain means, a film is formed over the turbine blade to cool it down at acceptable level. The heat transfer is given by the Hg is Tg multiplied by the Tg minus Tb. Now, in the open loop transpiration coolings, a few small holes are provided in the surface of the blade. Now, the coolant passing through the coolant passages mixed with the mixed with the gases, and the heat transfer is again given by Hg, Asg, Tg minus Tb. Now, the results of this research are discussed in the these slides. Here, the plant efficiency versus plant specific work variation is shown for the SIBGT, that is the steam injected basic gas turbine cycle using the air film cooling, is given. Now, the same plot using the AICC cooling means, that is the convection cooling means, and this diagram shows the variation of plant efficiency with the plant specific work for the same SIBGT cycle using the transpiration cooling, air transpiration cooling. Now these three graphs which I had shown you, that I have shown you, that are plotted for different cooling means. Now it may be observed that in all the cases of cooling means, at any turbine inlet temperature, the plant efficiency increases with the increase in the compressor pressure ratio RP. At any turbine inlet temperature, except above the compressor pressure ratio 27, the plant specific work first increases and then decreases with increase in the compressor pressure ratio. Now this particular characteristic is because of the fact that increase in the turbine inlet temperature increases the turbine work. Meanwhile, compressor work remains same for any value of the compressor pressure ratio, which results in the increase in the plant specific work. As the higher value of turbine inlet temperature demands slight increase in the plant fuel consumption, the value of plant efficiency increases. Now for higher value of compressor pressure ratio, the outlet temperature of the compressed air increases, which in turn lowers the amount of the fuel required for generation of same value of turbine inlet temperature. Although the slight increase in the compressor work is observed for higher compressor pressure ratio, but the higher value of compressor pressure ratio also increases the turbine work, which in turn compensates the loss. Owing to these facts, the plant efficiency increases. It may also be observed that there is a discontinuity after the compressor pressure ratio 27, which may be due to the increased air temperature at the exit of the compressor, requiring a gradually decreasing fuel flow rate to get given turbine in that temperature. There may be requirement of cooling rather than heating in the combustor. Hence, the results after the compressor pressure ratio 27 are not reliable. Now, this particular graph gives you the comparison of the plant specific work for the different configurations as explained, different configurations explained earlier. You may observe that for the turbine inlet temperature 1700 Kelvin, compressor pressure ratio 21, and compressor pressure ratio for the low pressure compressor 1.5 and the pressure ratio 1.5 for the HTP, you may observe that the SIIC RGT is showing the better performance than the other configuration. Now this results are shown for the AICC cooling means. Now, if the cooling means is AFC, that is the air film cooling, then the again the SIIC RGT is the better performer. For ATC also, ATC cooling means, that is transpiration cooling means, SIIC RGT is again the better performer. Now, if the plant efficiencies are compared for all the configurations, for AICC cooling means, the head cycle shows the better performance. And in case of air film cooling, again the head cycle is showing the better performance. In ATC, using ATC cooling means, head cycle is giving you the better performance, that is about 56.30%. Now, seeing all these results, the few conclusions may be drawn. These conclusions are, mixed cycles offer high plant efficiency and plant specific work compared to basic gas turbine. There is an appreciable enhancement in the mixed cycle specific work, that is 12 to 16%, and enhancement in efficiency of about 2 to 4% over the basic gas turbine, but of course at the cost of the complexity of the plant. The performance of steam injected intercooled reheat gas turbine cycle is better than all the considered configuration. The intercooling pressure ratio plays an important role on the performance. The stack temperature in steam injected cycles is higher, signifying the less utilization of waste heat energy. However, a separate provision of steam generation in HRSG for cogeneration may serve the purpose. The uncontrolled NOx emissions are expected to be very low due to addition of humid air or steam in mixed cycle power plant. Carbon monoxide, unburned hydrocarbons and sulfur oxides are expected to be at low level. The effect of compressor pressure ratio on cooling flow requirement is negligible for all the three cooling means, that is AICC, ATC and AFC. The cooling flow requirement increases with the increasing turbine inlet temperature. Now, about the cooling means, AICC cooling method is recommended if the plant efficiency is of main consideration. Transpiration cooling method is suitable if the specific work is of main consideration. The performance of humid air turbine cycle is noticeable among all the considered configuration, but of course at the cost of complexity of the plant setup. Now, there are further possibilities of research in this area, and few possibilities which may be further attempted are economic study of configuration may be worked out to estimate the specific capital cost. A detailed feasibility study can also be attempted for each configuration, considering all the practical aspects. Optimization of individual elements of different configuration can also be attempted. Better mathematical models may be prepared for every components and may be developed for real situation also. Better cooling model may be developed. Other type of bed cooling techniques can also be investigated. More sophisticated cyclic configurations leading to higher plant efficiency may be considered and may be studied further. Now, what is the level of NOx, SOx in the exhaust that may further be investigated? The effect of inlet air cooling through fogging and refrigeration system may also be studied. Here we have used unfired HRSG. Now fired HRSG may also be used. These are the references which are used in these studies. Thank you.